Since youth make up more than 75% of the population, their development is essential to the advancement and long-term viability of communities and countries. However, in several communities, many of the youth remain redundant and therefore are a burden rather than a blessing to their communities. In order to ensure that youth are productive in their communities, the civil society has embarked on mentoring and training young people. Matthew Musawo, one of the beneficiaries of a mentorship program in Chiriandongo, explains how his life has been transformed.
When I came back to Chiriandongo after the training, my confidence had stepped up. And my fellow leaders were able to tell that a lot has changed about me. I gained more confidence. I would debate more freely in council because I knew my rights and I knew that I had to advocate for the young people. And because of that, I got elected to represent our district council in one of the secondary schools, which is in the settlement.
Musau explains that after the training, they managed to establish an organization that mentors young people into responsible citizens as well as equipping them with other important skills.
They call facilitated film screening. Now, facilitated film screening is we go into a village and look at the problems that these people face. Like one that we've done most recently was shortage of water in the settlement. We took our cameras, spoke to the women, spoke to the young people in the village, and they told us what they were facing. The challenge was water was not enough. So we captured this film and showed it to the relevant authorities, and as we speak, our people in the settlement have enough water.
Even when many people doubted his capacity, Musau explains that he used the skills attained to rise through to one of the top leadership positions in the district. He now rallied young people not to give up on their dreams.
It lived in me, first of all, when I tried to want to stand. I spoke to a lot of people, but every one of them told me I couldn't make it, including some of my family members. They looked at the background and said, "Why am I wasting time?"
The mentorship programs organized by Action Aid International Uganda, aimed at empowering young people through leadership development, young people are not only given the tools they need to succeed in their personal and professional lives, but are also better prepared to become effective change agents in their communities and beyond.
The platform has been key in capacity building for young people, promoting young people's participation in key decision-making spaces. Recently, the global platform supported young people to go and participate in the ULEAD Summit, which is a regional summit that is a space for young people to engage their leaders across the East African region.
Munduru explains that the initiative has also been pivotal in advocacy for climate change, democracy and human rights. Hundreds of youths have been transformed.
An increased consideration and prioritization of youth across government planning, across government sectors, across conversations. There are now no conversations without young people. We've seen them participate in climate change conversations at national level, and we're really proud to say that SPA2 lit this candle and has continued to provide space for young people and their organizations to engage at all levels.
Story compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.